how my keywords will go on to get into my design process. Mask, abstract, pessimism, aimless, transparent, cocoon, lost.
A design journal is also called as a process book, a learning journal, reflective journal, or a research journal. There might be a bit of difference in their understanding, but for a fashion designer, they all are pretty much the same. So what is it and why do designers need it? To understand that, let's see this fashion show. From the show, we learned that these fashion designers has to make almost 100 or more pieces for this collection. And obviously for that, a designer requires a lot of elements like prints and graphics, textiles, new color palette, new silhouettes, new surface ornamentation techniques, and the works. And this is not just the end of the story. The challenge is to create all the pieces which looks like a part of the same family, which would be different, but will still have a little bit of similarity. So this is something that is called a collection. For creating such collections with homogeneous pieces, the biggest tool for a fashion designer is the design process. And this design process is a fascinating journey that starts with an inspiration, and with a lot of research and conceptualization, it finally brings you to the collection of seven pieces. It is easy to understand that this design process is very intensive and organic in nature. So every designer needs to document this. This documentation of design process is done in a design journal. Just like you have seen movies have behind the scene or making of the movie documentation, a design journal has all the thoughts, ideas, and unique vision of a designer. So today we are very fortunate to have our brightest fashion student to take us through her design journal. So let's have a look.
So can you tell us about your collection and please introduce yourself?
My name is Ashima Sharma. This is my collection. This started off as depression, that I wanted to work upon the illness depression. But later on, it went on that how depression just doesn't affect the victim, but also how it affects the family and friends of the victim who are surrounded all the time with them. So that is how I started with it, and suddenly I realized how much it affects everyone who is within that vicinity of the person. So my collection is called Prism of Pessimism. That is how everything gets evolved with the person. So this is my mood board, that how a person, even though he wants to get out of it, can't really get out of it, how caged he feels, how trapped he feels all the time, and he can't even speak out his mind, because the victim will also feel affected because of that. So that is how I came up with the whole idea after getting all my mood boards and everything done.
So what are the keywords for your mood board?
Keywords were chaotic, tangled, vague, translucent, engulfed, masked, and exhausted.
Okay, so what is this page?
This is all my keywords, that how my keywords will go on to get into my design process. Mask, abstract, pessimism, aimless, transparent, cocoon, lost.
So this is the way you do your brainstorming?
Yes.
Okay, and after this, what happened?
After this, I went ahead.
What is this image? What is this?
This means how, because of one person, the other person also gets trapped into the depression of that person. Then I went ahead and did some fabric sourcing. That's my fabric sourcing that I did, and these are my final fabrics that I finally selected out of them.
So how did you figure out these particular fabrics in this particular colors?
After I had done with my mood board, the mood was looking very dark. So that is how I came with my colors such as grays and blacks. And that is how I started researching about my fabrics also, that they should have a sheer, translucent kind of feel to them. And then also they should contradict to the other fabrics, so there should be a solid fabric with them also. So that is how I started getting my fabrics, that there should be all the elements mixed together. Then I started off doing my samples, mixing of two fabrics, because I wanted to play with my fabrics only, not embroidery or anything else. So that is how I started with my the samples. All the samples are created by me using the different fabrics that I had finally selected. Then later on, after I had done with them, I had started with the drapes to look how the finally fabric will fall.
So which technique you have used for drapes?
For drapes, I was looking for a deconstructed drape look, because in depression, nothing is concrete. Everything is vague and everything is deconstructed. So that is how I got my keyword deconstruct, and that is how I started my deconstructed drape. That nothing should be like, this is done, these are just normal cowls, no.
Alright, so the keywords that you said in the beginning, they are also being showcased in the forms that you're trying to create.
Yes.
How many days it took for you to create these many forms?
At least a week.
Is a week?
Okay. Yeah.
And you were clicking it.
I spend day and night doing the drape sometimes.
Okay. Alright.
Then after the drapes, after thorough discussion and everything, I started with my silhouettes and what fabric would be put in the silhouettes.
Okay. So you did sketching, initial sketches, or you started with making ensembles directly?
No, I did start with product wise. So some jackets, some trousers, some dresses. But right now they are randomly placed.
Yeah. Okay, so this is, so these fabrics are suggestive of where they would be,
where
put,
they
in
would
the,
be put
in the garment.
So like in this one, I had initially thought of a dress, but later on when I saw it, I thought it needed a jacket, so I put up a jacket with it. So these are the jacket flats.
Yeah. All right. So I see there's a lot of geometricity in the forms that you are doing.
I wanted to give them a oversized cocooned feel to them, so that's why.
Alright, so when you're doing these sketches, I'm not seeing references of all the cows that you did. So that
cows
was intentional.
No, it comes on.
Okay, it will come later. Okay.
Yeah. These were all the tops that I did.
Okay, so that was the process you took.
Yeah.
So you started working on a single garment. Then you built up the whole story.
Yes. Some dresses that I did. There comes the cowl.
Okay, at this stage you started incorporating all the cowl exercise that you did. So are you satisfied with your sketches, or you still want to do more?
If given an opportunity, yes. But then there's no time.
I know. Okay, so then how did you figure out all this? So these are your final range?
Yes.
Okay. So your final range, how would you describe your final range? Okay, so you have flattened the back.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so can you just explain this? Okay, so this is your flask.
Yes. I wanted all my elements to come together. So that is how I got into that. My whole range should be cohesive of everything that I have done till now. So that is how I got into like two fully draped garments, two deconstructed simple garments, I would say, and one that has the elements of both of them together.
So these garments have yet not been rendered, but they pretty much give the idea of how the garments
look. Yeah.
So which software are you using to do your flag sketch?
Photoshop.
Photoshop?
Yes.
Photoshop? So you look like Illustrator.
No. Really? Yeah.
This is Photoshop?
Yeah.
Oh, you master Photoshop. Yes, I do. I cannot work on Illustrator. Wow. So where did you learn this? I mean, because this is expert work.
I've learned it from my mentor in internship.
Ah, in your internship. Where was your internship?
In Rocky, yes. Rocky Star.
Okay. So there you had to do a lot of flats?
No, actually, we used to sketch. Then he actually taught me how to take it forward. So that is how I learned it.
Brilliant.
Thank you.
I think you're... So can you just briefly explain the kind of silhouettes that you have?
My silhouettes have a feel of a deconstructed feel to them and a cocooned feel to them. So that is like this is a deconstructed kimono. Like the side seams would be open and then there would be boning, which we would normally not see in a kimono. Then there comes a mesh dress beneath it, which will give the translucency it needs. For this one also, there's a deconstructed drape skirt happening with a deconstructed shirt. Like the pan, that like it has elongated placket and the panels are also not stitched together.
Alright, so can you show me the sketch for this?
Yes.
Thank you so much, Ashima, for sharing your story, your journey of your design process. It was amazing. I'm so excited, elated, and today was an inspiring day. Thank you so much.